an eerie sight, for my monster from his slab began to rise. And
we are back working on Dr. J, and I did a little bit more work to him last night. We've got some of the shading on his jacket, so it doesn't look so flat. And then I had to do some filler work around the arm. I completely missed that there were some holes here. It's not a very good fit between his forearm and his upper arm. And I completely missed the holes. So I got some Vallejo acrylic putty in there, and we're going to have to touch that up because I didn't like seeing them holes there. We've got some coloring added to his face and arms. I don't know if the camera can pick it up. Let me take the camera off the tripod real quick here. I added a little bit of red to his skin tone. Again, I was trying to get to that look of not only his face being flush, but his arm from drinking the special elixir there out of his flask. I didn't want to go too heavy on the flushing because then he'd look like a clown. So, you know, it's kind of hard to find that right balance between, you know, just enough and too much. But I think we've got, I don't know if it shows up on camera because my camera doesn't do a very good job of picking up subtle stuff. But I think here in person, anymore, he's going to look a bit silly. So I'm just going to stop and just leave it right there. But we've got a little bit more work to do on this lab coat. I'm going to do the pockets, but most of the shading on the lab coat is done, so now it doesn't look so two-dimensional. And I might do a little bit on his pants, but I think his pants are pretty good. I'm not going to mess with that much more. And his shoes, I'm leaving right where they're at. I think they're perfect. I've got some of the flasks put together. These are the duplicates. We got a set in glow-in-the-dark, and then a set in the white plastic. I'm going to use both sets. But the main reason for doing this video is to take a look at some of the pieces, parts that are in the Monster Scenes Gruesome Goodies, which Mobius has put out the whole series of, well, almost all the whole series of Monster Scenes. Another company, I can't think of the name right now, has just released two kits that Aurora never got around to put in production. I guess this company found the molds and said, hey, this would be cool to finish these up and produce a couple more that Aurora never did. And if you want to see those two kits, again, you can go over to our Saturn 9 Richie's channel. I'll put a link up here because Richie's building the whole set. I think he's got every single one of these Monster Scenes. And you can take a look at the two new ones that they just released. This hasn't been out, it's been out for a while. It's not like a brand new release thing. But this is the Gruesome Goodies, and it has everything you see on the box art is what you get. You get all the lab equipment, you get the skull, the big fang-toothed bunny. You got the generator here, and this generator piece here. So you get everything you see on the box art. You get both tables and all kinds of stuff. What we're going to use mainly out of this Gruesome Goodies kit is the glassware, because it's similar to what we see on the box art on the Mr. Hyde kit. Dr. Jekyll, Mr. Hyde kit. So we'll be using mainly the glassware. I'm really going to be using, I might use the skull maybe, maybe the rats, but everything else we'll just save it for something else down the road. All the glassware is done in a clear plastic, and here's the case for the bunny, and then here's all the test tubes and all the other stuff here that we'll probably use the most of. We've got our Bunsen burner, which is in clear, test tubes, these glass jars and stuff. So we got all that in clear, so we'll be using mainly this tree right here. I might use the skull out of the kit. I don't know yet, but Everything else we're not going to be using. It's pretty cool stuff though. I mean, the generator is really cool. And all the generator pieces. The table is really cool, actually. As I said earlier, these are either 1/12 or 1/13 in scale. So if you in the dollhouse making and you're looking for some mad scientist work for your dollhouse, you can get these kits and they'd be in the same scale. Because these are actually pretty nice. And they're much cheaper than buying actual dollhouse stuff. I paid $15 for this. And while you can get lab equipment in dollhouse supplies, they're like 40, 50 bucks. So you're looking at 15 versus 40 or 15, you're getting all this other stuff. But here are some of the generator pieces, which are pretty cool. And then the table. Oh, here's the giant bunny and the rat. And here's the test tube holder, which is done in wood grain, as well. A little too close to the camera. There we go. And then here's the rat, the skull, and the other half of the bunny. Come on, focus. There we go. Sometimes it takes a while for the camera to focus. It's usually quicker than that. So there's that. And then the tables are really nice in this kit. Like I said, they give you two. The wood grain in them is really, really nice. You can kind of see that wood grain in the tables. Really heavily ingrained, so you can really make these look like wood pretty easy. And then you got your legs, and those are done in the same wood grain pattern. So, you know, 15 bucks, you're getting all this stuff. I think it's not a bad deal at all. So, that's just a quick look at the monster scenes and but the main reason I wanted to do this is to show you the Gruesome Goodies kit, and they're pretty cool. So we'll keep working on this and adding our accessories, and he's almost finished. We got too much more other than hooking up the lighting and add a switch and all the other fun stuff. But I'd say he's about 80% done. Okay, so we're getting long in the video, so I just wanted to show you the Gruesome Goodies real quick, and then we'll continue working on Dr. J here and get them all done. So until then, guys, take care, and we'll see you in the next update.
I was working in the lab late one night when my eyes beheld an eerie sight, for my monster from his slab began to rise. And suddenly, to my surprise,
he did the mash.
He did the monster mash.
The monster mash.
It was a graveyard smash.
He did the mash.
It got on.